Assalamu alaikum students, I am Dr. Hawa Bitool and today our practical is pregnancy test. What we are going to learn today is that what is the procedure of this test, physiological basis of test and significance of human chorionic gonadotropin hormone, that is the basis of detecting pregnancy during this test. Now, what is the role of HCG? After fertilization, HCG production starts from the trophoblastic layer. And what is its function? That it is necessary to keep corpus luteum functioning for estrogen and progesterone production. Afterwards, when the placenta has developed and starts to produce estrogen and progesterone, the concentration of HCG in the blood of mother starts to decrease. Here we are detecting human chorionic gonadotropin in the initial 12 to 14 days after conception in the maternal urine. So our principle is that we detect concentration of HCG hormone after 12 to 14 days of conception. This pregnancy test or urine pregnancy strip test is a test which is a qualitative test. This strip is a test kit for determining HCG in the urine sample only. It is only a qualitative, it gives us only a qualitative results. What does it mean? That it will only tell us that whether our test is positive or negative, that is whether pregnancy is present or not. Now students, let us see for a while that what is the structure of our pregnancy strip. As you can see, and we will show you shortly, that a pregnancy strip has a lower marking which shows maximum with downward arrows. This marking shows that you should not dip our pregnancy strip above this level in the urine sample. Now these two figures show us that what negative result looks like and what does positive result look like. For this purpose, let us study the zones which are present normally in a pregnancy strip. First one, the reaction zone. This zone contains antibodies for HCG alpha chain. When the urine test strip is dipped in the urine sample, the enzymes bind to this antibody. In the absence of HCG in the urine, the enzymes will remain unbound, but they will pass along the strip upward. If HCG is present, they will bound the enzymes present in the reaction zone. After this, we have this test zone. This contains polyclonal anti-human chorionic gonadotropin antibodies plus a dye substance that will react only when the antibodies are activated, indicating pregnancy. If HCG is present in the alpha chain specific antibodies in the reaction zone of the test before reaching the test zone, the polyclonal antibodies and the colored reagent, they are mobilized in the presence of bound molecules. So, a colored strip in the test zone will appear if HCG is present in the urine and it is bound with the enzymes present in the reaction zone. The third zone above the test zone is control zone. As you can see, it shows a colored line both in the cases of a negative and a positive result. Now what does it contain? The control zone, it serves to validate that whether the test has been performed successfully or not. As I have already mentioned, that bound anti-HCG enzymes from the reaction zone interact with the body antibodies in the test zone. Unbound enzymes continue to be drawn upwards along the test strip to the control zone. So here they will react with the third antibody and then mobilize a second dye substance, which will give us a colored line in the control zone. So whether HCG is present in the urine sample or not, the unbound enzymes will always mobilize a dye, which will give us a control zone, indicated that we have performed the test successfully. Now we are going to perform our pregnancy test. For this experiment, what we need is a sterile container, which should be clean, for the collection of urine sample and pregnancy strips. For the pregnancy strips, always remember that this packet should not be opened already, and also note the expiry date mentioned on the packet. Now students, you can see that we have collected a urine sample in our sterile container. Please take note that the sample collected should be a morning sample preferably, because the quantity of HCG is higher in the morning samples. Now I am going to open this container so that we can proceed with our steps. In the first step, we have collected the urine in the sample. Now we are going to open our pregnancy strip. I have noted the expiry date. It is up to date. Always remember to wear sterile gloves. After opening the package, use the pregnancy strip as soon as possible. I am taking out the pregnancy strip. You can see a blue line on the underside of the strip, which shows maximum. This is the point from where you should not immerse the strip upwards. This should be the maximum level up till where the pregnancy strip should be dipped into the sample. Now, keeping this arrow downwards, we will immerse the strip into the sample up to this mark and wait for 30 seconds. Now after 30 seconds, we will take out the strip and place it on a clean, non-absorbent surface, looking for the control line to appear. As you can see here, a control line in the control zone has been appeared, which shows that the test has been performed successfully. Now, for the other line to appear, we will wait for next 5 minutes. Now students, as you can see, after waiting for 5 minutes, the second line has not been appeared in the test zone. We have only achieved one line in the control zone. This shows that our pregnancy strip test is negative in this case.